Yo, what is up, guys? It's the Goblin. In today's video, what we're going to be doing is we're going to be spectating one of the best players in Call of Duty Black Ops 3 in the world. And this is him, Tiger Insidious. Basically, he's a level 700. I was looking to find the number one players in the world, and I found a lot of people just play the game a lot. This guy plays the game a lot, and he's absolutely insane at it. He only has 12 days played. He's level 700. He has a 1,000 score per minute. This guy is crazy, and I found him through the hardpoint leaderboards. He has like 10 times the amount of kills as everyone else on the hardpoint leaderboards. His stats, you can see, obviously he runs non-lethals, and he keeps up a 1,000 score per minute in hardpoint. There it is, 1,018 score per minute, a 3KD. This guy wins a lot, and he's a very good player. So we're going to be spectating a game of his here on some hardpoint Nuketown, and hopefully you guys will enjoy this. If you guys can, I'll drop a like on this video. I'd absolutely appreciate that. And as you guys can see from the leaderboards right here, the other people on the leaderboard have 2,000 kills. He has 30,000 kills. So even though he's number 10, as far as consistency and straight up, you know, performance, he's probably number one in the world as a hardpoint player. So hopefully you guys will enjoy this. Let's cut right into me watching him play some hardpoint, and drop a like on this thing, boys. Alright, what is up, guys? This is the Goblin, and today we're not playing the game. I don't have my hands on the controller. We're spectating Tiger Insidious, and look at that. Okay, this guy's one of the best hardpoint players in the world for public matches, and look how he starts off there with the jump spot. Oh my, what the hell? Okay, this guy has incredible movement. I think that's the difference. Like, someone like me that's played COD for years, I'm not really that into the new movement system, but this guy seems like he's definitely into that movement system, and this is something that I need to do to improve my game personally, is, you know, fix my movement a little bit more and use these jump spots. So look at the class that he's using. He's using the RK5 and the, oh my god, another good jump shot, but then he gets messed up there. He's already 7-2, Tiger is. He's using the M8 with quick draw, elo, and stock. So that's exact, this is like the exact same class that I use. I'm not sure what perks he has on right now, but he's using non-lethal killstreaks, the Tempest, M8, and RK5. This is like a pretty similar class to what I use. And we'll just spectate and see how this guy does play, because this guy is like one of the number one ranked players in the world for hardpoint. He's probably the best hardpoint player in the world for public matches. And it's absolutely crazy. This guy keeps like a 3.5 KD and all that stuff, and also keeps his score per minute up. So let's spectate him and see what he does here with this M8. So he's coming around the back. Yeah, this guy definitely does use the movement system really well. And you'll see he likes to whip out the RK5 pistol whenever he's at close range. I think that's something that, like, a lot of... It looks like he's playing, like, a competitive match in a public match, if that makes sense. Like, this is a class setup that competitive players use. If you ever watch any competitive Call of Duty, maybe you like Optic or FaZe or whatever, they always use the M8A7 with the RK5 secondary. There, when he pulled out the Tempest, he did a little trick to pull out the Tempest a little bit faster. I think he's... Oh, my gosh. Oh, my goodness. Oh my, you missed that shot. But this guy definitely has some good aim, and he definitely is a pretty good player. And I was looking through his recent games, it looks like he plays Nuketown every time for hardpoint. Obviously, if he keeps up 1,000 score per minute or whatever, it's pretty much going to be Nuketown only, or going to be the smallest map, which is Nuketown. Like, if you look at people's, that's why people's stats really aren't that accurate in Call of Duty, because certain people are going to have, you know, like maybe 100 or 200 less score per minute while they're the same skill of a player, just because they like to play Redwood and stuff while the other guy plays Nuketown 24 hours a day, similar to what I do. So he's running the non-lethal killstreaks, and what non-lethals are, oh my goodness, he's going ham at this hardpoint right now. He's running the UAV, the counter UAV, and the Hater, and he does a very good job here at pre-firing the corners. And he's on like a 15, okay, he's on the, he was on like a 15 gun streak there. It didn't look like he really cared about the nuclear. I'm not sure how many, this guy probably has a bunch of nuclears. It's the same with me when I play sometimes. Like, I really don't care about nuclears. Once I start going ham, I just try to go as ham as I can. So, right now, he's already doing very well. And still using that M8 class. I think he's probably going to use this. He has the gem cam on it, but he probably, I don't know if this guy even has dark matter. You think, like, if you're like a full-on tryhard, like, for me personally, I was at like a 3 KD or something in Call of Duty, and then I started going for dark matter, and then I was at like a 2.4 or 2.5 KD, because obviously using those crappy guns, look at these jump spots. I never even like really knew about these spots. I definitely have to use those, and that's something we could all learn from watching this, is jumping off, just like this, just like Tiger Insidious does. He jumps off those spots, and his movement is very crisp, and that's something you'll notice, like, a lot of good players in Black Ops 3. I think that this is like one thing I could really improve on. Obviously, I have a good shot. Obviously, I know how to play Call of Duty. I've been playing for years, but I'm not really that in tune with the with how the movement works in Black Ops 3 and all that stuff. And it seems like he likes to use the Tempest. I think the Tempest and the Scythe are what, you know, people that go for the most score. Oh my goodness, they go for the most score per minute. What the hell? Oh my gosh. Five man. Okay, he just got a quad feed with the Tempest. Yo, that was cool. He's doing the thing. If you guys wonder how you do that boost, it's basically when you hop onto a surface, you boost slide off of the surface, and you can go pretty quick off of it. So he's already doing some work here with these non-lethal killstreaks. I think obviously, like, if you're going for score per minute, UAV and counter UAV and VSAT or Hater are the best ways to get up your score per minute. That is, like, pretty much undeniable. And that's, like, if I use this setup, usually I can pull, like, 10,000 score per each match on Nuketown. Let's see how many score. I'm sure he's going to get at least 10,000 this game. It seems like he's already going ham, and this game has just begun. Definitely the M8 is, like, it's undoubtable. The M8 is one of the best guns in the game. I'd say the best guns are M8, Man of War, and VMP. And, like, if you watch... I know I talk about, like, competitive a lot, but if you do watch competitive, you can learn a lot about, like, obviously the people in competitive Call of Duty, if you just think about it logically, people who are playing competitive Call of Duty, they're the people that are going to be, they're playing for money, you know, they're playing for the win all the time, so they're going to use the best gun. They're not going to mess around and pull out a stupid gun, and they're going to use the best guns all the time. And obviously, if you put that mindset into public matches, where in public matches, you'll have people running around with the sword. Yeah, look at that jump spot. If you run high on the wall and then jump like that, people don't even see you coming at all. It's absolutely crazy. Oh my gosh. Yo, I'm definitely going to have to use that. I'm sure he has Afterburner on. Anyone who uses the movement system well. Yo, watching this guy's gameplay makes me... I have to hop on. It's Nuketown 24-7 this weekend. I'm definitely playing tonight. I just hit, like, level 400. I recorded a video for that, and I'm definitely going to be hopping on and playing some more Call of Duty Nuketown tonight. And it's really fun. It's, like, when you have the enemies counter UAV like this, and your movement is just so crisp, you're going to easily be able to take people out. And the RK5 is so powerful. I see people saying, like... People have been commenting saying or making videos saying the Rift E9, the new pistol, is the best secondary in the game. That is not true. One thing I hate about COD YouTube is people, and I mean, people call me out for this all the time, but honestly, I never say something is overpowered, or I never say this is the best new gun or whatever, if it's just, like, if it hasn't been buffed in any way, or, you know, YouTubers are too quick to say that. Like, the Rift E9, it's not the best secondary. The Banshee is not the best shotgun. The Banshee sucks. And the Rift E9, I don't have it, but it looks like it sucks as well. The RK5 is the best secondary in the game. And the LKAR9 and the Marshall, those are all better than the Rift E9. Probably even the MR6 is better too. And you'll see here, he doesn't have any, like, reloading things. He doesn't have extended mags or fast mags. I don't run either of those either when I run the M8. You really don't need it. And whenever he's low on ammo, he either just dips out to reload, or he swaps out to his pistol. Yeah, the pistol, he definitely does like the pistol more than the M8 at close range. And that's something that pro players do as well. But back on the point, yo, he is, this guy is a definition of pub stomping. Tiger Insidious, this guy's crazy, level 700. I don't know how he finds so much time to play the game, but there's people that are really dedicated to Black Ops 3. Me personally, Black Ops 3 is like my job, right? I have 11 days played, I play a lot. I probably play more than 90% of YouTubers. That's a fact. Most YouTubers aren't even 10th prestige. I'm level 400. There are people that are above me. I think No Pomage is like level 600. FaZe Sprat is level 1000. Those guys grind more than me. He's on a 20 gun streak right now. Is he going to get the nuclear? Let's sit and watch. See if. Oh my gosh. They're all spawning on him right now. But this guy definitely plays the game a lot. People that have like 40 days played are absolutely crazy. And it seems like a lot of people really do like the new movement, and it's like a lot of people that's like, you always see, oh, he's on a Brutal right now. The Tempest does count for kills towards his new. He's probably gonna get the nuke here. He's like one or two off. Hold on. Oh no, they're spawning behind him. He's gonna pull out the RK5. Yeah, that was a good option to swap out from the Tempest. I think he's one off the nuclear right now, so he's probably gonna get it. His team is just dominant. Did he get it? Oh my gosh, he's still one off. He's gonna, oh my god, he died. I think he died one off the nuclear there. See, this guy plays weird. Like, okay, he didn't even care. He ran out in the middle when he was one off the nuclear. I would have sat back a little. I mean, come on. Maybe he didn't know. He must not have seen the Brutal. Or maybe he did get the nuclear and I just missed it. But that was kind of a weird playstyle. Maybe it just didn't pop up, or I just missed it because I was yammering on. You guys can let me know in the comments. But that was kind of weird if he did fail that nuclear. That was kind of weird. But basically, you guys know what I mean. These people love the game and love the movement system. And I think Black Ops 3 is a great game. I find the maps are the issue. Like, if you guys watch me, you watch, I like to play Nuketown, I like Combine, I like Aquarium, I like a lot of those maps. Breach is a really good map, Fringe is a really good map. But then we get to maps like Redwood and maps that just, they use the wall running and they make the map a bit too big with the wall running there. Like, there he got a bit greedy going for that kill. He probably should have waited out and sat on that one. I'm not sure how many kills he's at right. Oh my gosh. Yeah, he does the same. It's sort of just playing patterns. He does this, like, he's going to do it again, right? Yeah, he does the same sort of wall runs and jump spots over and over. And that's what you can learn. I definitely think that watching competitive Call of Duty can help you in public match. He's already at 150. 15,000 score. What the fudge? Holy crap, this guy's going off. And this guy is basically the number one player, one of the number one players in the world on Black Ops 3. Not by complete score, but by score per minute. I'd rank this guy as number one in the world just because he is number 10, I think, exactly. But other people have a 10th. It doesn't matter if you play 10 hard points and you're really good. If this guy plays 100 and he's just as good as you, he's a better player. Obviously, he's more consistent. And it's insane to be able to get over a 1,000 score per minute. That means he averages 10th. What a hard point is probably 10 minutes a time. Or like it could be 12 or 13 minutes. So he averages at least 10,000 score a game. And this game, obviously, he has a 15,000 score or whatever, which is absolutely crazy. But this class is definitely really good. M8A7, Quick Draw Elo Stock, and the RK5 Secondary. I would recommend this class to anyone. I've used this class myself. You know, this is a standard good class for public matches. It absolutely stomps. The Elo and Red Dot is just personal preference. And he's going in here. His team's about to win the game. 15,000 score. Absolutely crazy gameplay from Tiger Insidious right here. And, you know, this is what happens. How do you guys get good at COD? You always ask. You got to watch videos. You got to learn. And you also got to play the game a lot. And playing the game a lot is definitely the number one tip towards learning. That's definitely the thing. 123 kills. The recording stops right here, but the game's almost over. He gets like 16,900 score. Yep, it's almost 17,000 score. 123 kills. Absolutely crazy gameplay there. Hopefully you guys did enjoy this. Absolutely crazy. Spectating one of the number one players ranked in the world. Please drop a like on this video if you guys didn't make it to the end. And comment number one down in the comment section down below. Absolutely awesome to watch some other people's gameplay other than myself for once. And I can even learn some things from these great players. Obviously this guy is an outstanding player at Call of Duty Black Ops 3. Thanks for watching guys. Subscribe for Cookie and Don't Lookie. And I'm out. Peace.